Alright, so in this video we're going to be talking through a few of the things that you need to know about these two guys, Montezuma and Cortez. So this is what your chart should look like that you're filling out right now. You can fill out your information right here about Montezuma and Cortez. The what, the where, and the outcome. And we're going to be talking through a lot of that in this video. So here's what you need to know according to the standards. Describe the encounter and consequences of the conflict between the Spanish and Aztec and Incas and the roles of Cortez, Montezuma, Pizarro, and Atahualpa. So in this station, again, you're talking about Cortez and Montezuma. Kind of give you a little bit of background with the Aztecs. At the time of European exploration, the Aztec civilization, it was really one of the most powerful of all the civilizations in Central and Southern Mexico. And if you would put them up against other civilizations in the world, they're one of the most powerful civilizations at this time also in the world. And so it's a very complex, very rich society. They're not barbaric, as some of the Europeans would look at them and try to say. But again, it's a very complex society. They controlled the area around their capital city, Tenochtitlan, and it's now Mexico City. So when we talked about geographical concepts in Central America, Mexico City, the capital city of Mexico, used to be known as Tenochtitlan. Borders stretched from the Gulf of Mexico over here to the Pacific Ocean, basically the middle part of modern-day Mexico. They controlled lands as far south as present-day Guatemala as well. And the Aztec civilization ended in 1521. It was conquered by the Spanish, and that's what we're going to talk about with the interaction between Cortez and Montezuma. They destroyed a lot of the Aztec buildings, a lot of these pyramids that they had built, and a lot of their artwork. They completely destroyed the city of Tenochtitlan, so there's really nothing that's left as much of that city, but they built Mexico City in its place. So starting with Hernan Cortez, he was a Spanish conquistador, and basically all that means he's a conqueror. He goes and he's one of the guys sent by the Spanish Empire to take over certain new lands and create new colonies. He's famous for conquering the Aztec Empire in Mexico in 1519 and 1521. Anytime that you want to stop this video and add some more details to your chart, you can go ahead and do that. All right, so we're going to keep on going though. After his victory, the Spanish, they began to settle in Mexico, and they would retain control of Mexico for really the next 300 years. And so this is going to be a very, very strong colony for the Spanish Empire once they overtake the Aztecs. A little bit of background on Hernan Cortez. He was born in 1485. As a young man, he heard stories about the expeditions of Columbus. Of course, we know 1492, Columbus sailed the ocean blue. And so that's not really that far from when he was born. So it would have been when he was a young boy hearing stories about the expeditions of Columbus and the riches that are supposed to be found in the New World. And in fact, when he's 19, he sailed to the New World, and he got a job as a clerk. So he's very young, very ambitious, and he wants to have something, have some historical part in the exploration and colonization of the New World. He learned how colonies were run while he was in the New World as a clerk. He made a lot of contracts with Spanish explorers. After Cuba, the island of Cuba was conquered, Cortez was actually sent there. He was made mayor of one of the towns, so he definitely gets involved with the administration of these new colonies. 1518, Cortez is told that he should take a group of ships to Mexico, and he was ordered to conquer the powerful Aztecs. This is probably a very tall order for them to do, but with the zeal and the influence that the Spanish Empire had at this particular time, they probably didn't worry about the people that they were going to face as much. Remember, they're motivated by the three G's. Three G's, God, gold, and glory. And so they were definitely motivated in some instances to spread religion, to convert Christians. Definitely in this instance, they're motivated by wealth. The Aztecs had a lot of gold that they could take advantage of. And obviously glory to gain more influence. Landed in Mexico in 1519 with 11 ships, 500 soldiers, and 100 sailors. And so they feel like that they can pretty well take them on with that number. Cortez trained his men for several months, so it wasn't one of those things where he just showed up and expected to take over. He made friends with nearby Indians. He didn't like the Aztecs, and this was extremely important for him to do that, and it made a huge difference in his fight against the Aztecs. So by the time he marched on the Aztec capital city of Tenochtitlan, he had over 1,500 fighters. Over 1,000 were native people who wanted to fight the Aztecs, and we'll talk about why they didn't really like the Aztecs as much, and they probably had a good reason to not like them. The ruler of the Aztecs was Montezuma II, this guy right here. And due to the fact that Montezuma believed that Cortez might be the returning Aztec god Quetzalcoatl, he welcomed Cortez into the city. He didn't know he was there to conquer and to take over his empire, the Aztec Empire. He thought he was a returning Aztec god Quetzalcoatl. There was a tradition in their belief system that this god Quetzalcoatl was going to come back one day. And in Montezuma's eyes, maybe Cortez was this new god. And so he actually worshipped him in that sense. Once inside the city, Cortez and his men, they quickly took Montezuma captive. So they took advantage of his hospitality, but then took Montezuma captive. Cortez believed that he could control the Aztecs by keeping their leader hostage. So if he could just take them off at the top, then they would be good. Cortez was able to rule the lands of central Mexico for several months this way before problems started to begin. Obviously, when you lose your ruler, there's going to be issues that arise and that come up because of that. So a fight had broken out between Cortez's men and the Aztecs while Cortez was away. So he felt like if he could just come in there, take over the city, take their leader hostage, maybe it could be a smooth transition. He could just take over their empire altogether. But there are issues that had developed from that between the Aztecs and between Cortez's men. And so when Cortez had returned, battles had already had to be fought and to win back Tenochtitlan, this massive city that they had taken over. And you can see this is actually a city built kind of in the middle of a lake as well. So it's very interesting how the architecture was laid out. But it was in the middle of Lake Texcoco, and so very interesting city that the Aztecs had built. 1521, Cortez led a military victory over the Aztecs, and so he finally comes out, and they have this huge battle in 1521. From this time forward, the Spanish, they sent more troops and settlers into Mexico and began to claim it as their own. Just a little bit more about Montezuma II. He was the Aztec ruler from about 1500 to 1520. And so you definitely need to have some information included about Montezuma on your chart from this video. He was most famous for ruling the Aztecs when their land was invaded by the Spanish conquistador, Hernan Cortez. One of the reasons why I mentioned earlier how the some of the local tribes weren't particularly keen to Montezuma is because a lot of times when Montezuma, he would go and he would take over new tribes, any tribes that he conquered, he would use them, some of those people, as sacrifices to the gods because they felt like that they needed to appease the gods by their human sacrifices. This is something that the Aztecs were especially known for. The Spanish looked at and thought that was completely barbaric of them, but they felt like, the Aztecs felt like that if they didn't sacrifice human people to the gods, then their world would really cease to exist. They needed to appease the gods and to please them, and they felt like that this kept the world going. So obviously, people didn't want to be conquered by the Aztecs, and when they did, they lost a lot of their relatives, they lost people that they cared about because obviously, they would be taken up as sacrifices. So, didn't take much for Hernan Cortez to come in and try to get some of these tribes on their side because they both had a common enemy in the Aztecs. So, again, because of human sacrifices and because of the taxes that he had imposed on people that he conquered. Montezuma was pretty unpopular with those people that he conquered, but he was popular with his own people. He treated his own people well, and he was considered really a great ruler in the eyes of his own people. Again, the outcome is that the Spanish take over and they establish a strong colony there for the next 300 years.